Welcome back to This Is How I Science, a video series where we interview some of the science community's most brilliant and diverse minds.
I'm Dr. Henry Henderson, a cancer biologist, and this is How I Science.
My name is Sigourney. I'm a PhD student, and this is How I Science.
I just want to jump right in. You know, I'd love to hear about Black in Cancer, how it came about, what it means to both of you, and then I'd love to hear a little bit about both of you personally. But at least let's start with Black in Cancer and what it is.
Black in Cancer was what we like to call a movement, and it didn't start with us. So there was Black in Neuro, Black in Chemistry, Black in Astro, so a whole range of them. And both Henry and I realized that actually we didn't know many other people in our field that looked like us.
And under the principal aim of championing diversity in cancer research and medicine. And it's really a great thing to see people who look like you and some people to aspire to, especially when it comes to science, because we all want to reach out. We all want to learn from others' experiences. And sometimes we don't always have the same experiences. But if you share the same culture, you share the same values, you always have that thing in common to ask about. Sigourney's a graduate student and I'm a postdoctoral fellow. So we're like fresh scientists, right? For Black in Cancer, we're forming what we call the Cancer Awareness Project, is where we hold monthly seminars about cancers that affect the Black community. And unfortunately, that affects us in the worst way. And this is across all cancers. Educating our community and the community receiving the information from people who look like them mean a lot to us.
The other part and the other initiative that we're really keen on is what we call the BICPP, which is the Black in Cancer Pipeline Program. Our aim is to really provide mentors and mentorship schemes for young Black scientists, and also just moving forward, allowing people to see what careers that they can do within cancer research. Sometimes some things are so limited because we have a big belief in Black in Cancer that you can't be what you can't see. So if you can't see that person ahead of you, it's hard to know what you can aspire to. So what we're trying to do is create that visibility within the community so that people and young children in particular see scientists that look like them. I didn't meet another Black female scientist until I was 27.
It's so inspirational for anyone to watch this. Me just being someone who's interviewing you, it's still inspirational. I get goosebumps listening to you guys talk about this. I would love to hear a quick few minutes on what the future looks like for diversity, inclusion in STEM.
Yeah, the future, like you said, is bright. We have now with the availability of Snapchat, Instagram, TikTok, all the other talks, you have this platform, right, to express yourself scientifically, to show what you do in lab, to get others inspired. And so the future of STEM is bright. So many people are now interested in going to STEM fields. Even I'm inspired to keep going because you have other people who are looking at you to make awesome moves. I love my nephews, I have six of them. So when I tell them about what I do and how I'm helping people, it's amazing. And so I think the future of STEM is bright.
That's great.
Yeah, I would entirely agree. I think, like Henry said, social media has been such a powerful tool in terms of, Black in Cancer never would have been formed had it not been for Twitter and a conversation and the hashtag. And, you know, we had a social media week and we met so many incredible Black cancer scientists. We met people who had suffered from cancer, who were inspired by what we were doing, who used us as people to ask questions to about cancer. We had a kind of opportunity for people to talk about their experiences, for them to find out. And I think science feels a lot more open now in terms of people being able to ask the questions that they want to ask, to become more informed about science from so many different aspects, and that you don't necessarily, you know, I don't think it all relies on you having good science teachers in school that you absolutely love to still love STEM, because there are so many opportunities to access STEM now. And I think now it's just more about visibility moving forward so that these children from all manner of backgrounds can see scientists that look like them and realize that whatever it is that they want to do, if they're interested in STEM, they can go and do it.
Well, if they listen to this interview, then they'll get very excited. That's for sure. Because both of you have very infectious personalities. You're obviously brilliant minds, but you also seem like brilliant people. Thermo Fisher Scientific and I want to hear from you. We want to hear how you promote awareness, how you promote inclusion. We want to see your photos and your videos using the hashtag, ThisIsHowISience.